What's up YouTube, this your main man AB the Hero back again with another video, and your boy Lavar Ball might be trying to recreate Chino Hills over there in Prinu, Lithuania. Now this is going to be a pretty quick video, but I wanted to give y'all this information. Alright, an article came out today in which Lavar Ball is saying one of his ideals to move forward in Prinu is to begin to bring a few more American players over who understand his system, right? As we know, Lavar Ball and the coaching staff have had a minimal amount of tension based on Lavar wants to run that super fast-paced offense scoring 150-plus points a game. And the coaching staff there, who is considered to be much more faster paced than typical Lithuanian style basketball, is still not ready to commit to that. But Lavar Ball is offering this idea. He would love to bring over LaMelo and LiAngelo's Chino Hills teammate, Eli Scott. Now, I'm sure y'all remember Eli Scott if you were following the balls when they were at Chino Hill. He was basically the Draymond Green of the team. He was going to give you your points, he was going to give you your rebounds, and he's going to give you assists and just be an overall defensive enforcer. Eli Scott right now is playing ball over at Loyola Marymount University, where he's averaging 13 points, 7 rebounds, and 2 assists per game. The article talks about Lavar making a promise to Eli's mom that he was definitely going to get him a scholarship and he was going to look after him. So the realization of Eli's scholarship has already happened. This could be a reality for a few reasons. With Jello potentially being drafted this year or assigned to an NBA team, you would only have LaMelo over there. So it would be cool to have Eli come over there and be a familiar face and a teammate and somebody who knows the system. To run it with LaMelo, he definitely is going to bring a different dynamic than Jello brings to the system, but nonetheless, he's still familiar with it. And the folks who are in charge and running the financials over in the Vytautas front office are realizing the impact that the Ball family is having financially on the team. Part of that is having American players over here. Now, if you put it in perspective, you have to think about this. This is an LKL team who is in last place, who has a strong fan base in the United States. Like that typically doesn't happen. You have folks in the United States who are buying jerseys for a last place LKL team. Now, also about the jerseys, they are actually on sale right now. They were like $100-something, but they down to like $76. If you want to cop a jersey, go ahead and cop the jersey. There are 4 Americans on the Vytautas team right now. Prior to the Ball family getting there, there were none. So they're open to bringing some more Americans over there to play in Prini. The other thing is there has been some thorough discussion around if they want to have LaVar Ball just coach the team. Now, Coach Virginia Seskis, who is the face of the franchise, the heart and soul, they would never fire him, but he has said that in an effort to try something new, he would be on board with stepping back for the team for a season. He's coached a lot of years, so he could take a year off and have a vacation. He'd be down for that if LaVar Ball wants to step in and try to coach. Now, LaVar says that he's definitely not ready to commit to that because he's hoping that Jello will get picked up in the NBA, and he wants to be here to help Jello get acclimated and maneuver and make moves around here. So he doesn't want to commit to that. But so with that being said, if you have LaVar back and then also can have an Eli Scott, a LaMelo, and a Jello, you almost got a Chino Hills prime team. But if Jello goes to the NBA, LaVar leaves, it's a cool idea to have Eli Scott over there just to have LaMelo play with one of his brothers and then have a familiar face over there in Vytautas. So this is some big, this could be a big deal. And I feel like what this shows you is why LaVar is continuing to like plan and dream so big, because all of these small maneuvers that he's trying to put in place seem to be working out. So the idea that if he can go over here and basically put on an exhibition with this Prinu team of this is how his influence may change a franchise's trajectory. This is kind of audition for NBA franchises. Like, look, you bring my boys here, this is the type of attention and this is the type of winning atmosphere that we're going to bring to your squad. Now, only time will tell if that's going to work, but this is your main man, AB the Hero. I'm out. Peace.